नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग।
आई फील डीपली प्रिविलेज्ड टू बी इनवाइटेड एज अ स्पीकर एट द रोटरी क्लब ऑफ बॉम्बे वेस्ट। आई वुड वांट टू बिगिन बाय थैंकिंग द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द क्लब डॉक्टर मनोज पटेल, द सेक्रेटरी हीमा दलाल, माय स्पेशल थैंक्स टू श्री अशोक भाई देवरा एंड श्री जयराज भाई थक्कर। वी ऑल आर गोइंग थ्रू एन unprecedented crisis, and this crisis calls for a major reset. We have to push the reset button. We all are facing the same storm, but we are in different boats. I can very confidently say that the word lockdown top the search on Google this year and for the years to come. The world has changed, and how. Recently, I was reading an article in New York Times. The article was written on the changes that are going to be incorporated in the curriculum of the Ivy League unis. The reporter was of the opinion that the universities are going to incorporate on how lockdowns can be, how lockdowns can actually disrupt the economy, and what measures and what precautions should be taken to avoid such a situation. So students who are learning management and students who are doing their MBAs will now get to learn the precautions that one needs to take if there is a lockdown in the future, pre and post lockdown precautions. Our Prime Minister, when the migrants problem was at its peak, said that it is a natural human tendency to go back home when faced with an insurmountable problem. Why did he say that? Because home is the ultimate panacea. Home is the ultimate antidote. And that is exactly what we are going to discuss today. I'm going to tell you how our homes can be instrumental in facilitating good health, success, peace, prosperity, and harmonious relationships. I am not going to go into the technical details of what Vastu is, what is the origin of Vastu, because I believe that each one of you knows what Vastu is. Rather than going into the origin of Vastu and discussing the fundamentals of the movement of energy and vibrations and directions, I would today want to share some very interesting Vastu tips. These tips will help you fight this problem of COVID-19. Head on. I will be starting my talk with a very interesting subject. Since the time of corona outbreak, we've been constantly sanitizing ourselves. We've been hand washing, we've been sanitizing our environment, we've been constantly disinfecting the furniture and the fixture. But do you know that there is a process of energy sanitization in Vastu? What does it mean? It means that there is a process of space cleansing, space purgation. There is a process through which we can actually nullify, mitigate, and neutralize the negative energy which is inherently present in our spaces. हमारे घरों में जो भी निषेधात्मक ऊर्जा है उस ऊर्जा को हम वास्तु के इन उपायों के द्वारा कंप्लीटली पूरी तरीके से नाबूद कर सकते हैं, उसे खत्म कर सकते हैं. दी टिप्स दैट आई एम अबाउट टू शेयर आई कम विथ डिस्क्लेमर. Please continue following the World Health Organization protocols that you've been following, like hand washing and sanitizing your spaces and sanitizing your environment. These tips are just supportive in nature, but they do help. Add salt to lukewarm water and start splashing, spraying or sprinkling that water from the northeast, come to the southeast, from southeast come to the southwest, and from southwest come to the north in a clockwise manner. Shan se agnya, agnya se nairutya, nairutya se vayavya. Aap gunguna pani lenge aur usme namak dalenge. Namak dalne ke baad us pani ko aap splash karenge in a clockwise manner. From northeast to southeast, from southeast to southwest, from southwest to northwest. The moment you do this, there is a protective shield which is created in and around your living space. And this shield actually protects you from negative vibrations or negative energy entering into your space. And also it neutralizes the inherent negative energy which is present in the spaces. This is a very powerful remedy. This is a very powerful cure. Allow sunlight to enter your homes. Sunlight is therapeutic. It heals, it cures, it is curative. Open the windows in the eastern and in the northern side of your homes. Morning sunlight is very, very powerful. These days, people usually keep their windows closed because there is so much of dust and noise and other things. People don't prefer opening their windows. But morning sunlight is very, very powerful. Morning sunlight also produces a happy hormone, which is called as serotonin. Serotonin is a hormone which kind of uplifts our spirits, which keeps us happy. So in countries where there is less of sunlight, or you know, there is a very long spell of winter, there are huge cases of depression. So we are blessed. We live in a country where there is sunlight almost 9-10 months in a year. Allow sunlight to enter your homes. Sunlight is a natural disinfectant. It kills the germs. It kind of enhances the environment. Sometimes it happens that, you know, there are, I visit a lot of places, so there are homes where there are no windows on the east side. In Bombay, these kind of situations do happen. Or even if there are windows, there is a tall structure which is blocking the sunlight. If that is the case, allow the evening sunlight to enter. But here you need to be a little cautious because evening sunlight has ultraviolet radiations. Too much of ultraviolet radiations are detrimental for health. They have disastrous ramifications. What you need to keep in mind is the evening sun rays, the evening sunlight is therapeutic before 1 hour of sunset. That is the time. So if the sunset is happening at 7 p.m., you can let the evening sunlight enter from 6 p.m. into your home. This should be done if there are no openings on the east side and you can't, for some reason, allow the morning sunlight to enter your homes. or you know, it is not possible for you to keep the windows open because of some work going down, and it just is not possible. Or else morning sunlight is one of the best things to have. Another powerful vastu remedy is to recite Om or Gayatri Mantra in conjunction with lighting a diya. We've been doing a lot of research on mantras. We've been studying the impact of mantras on the human energy field and also on the energy field of the spaces. And our research very clearly indicates that Gayatri Mantra is so powerful that it has the ability to nullify most of the negative energy which is present there in the spaces. But only reciting the Gayatri Mantra is not enough. You need to accentuate the vibrations of Gayatri Mantra by lighting a diya. Lighting of a flame is very, very important. The moment you light a diya and recite a Gayatri Mantra in your living spaces, it actually gives you results of what a Gayatri Havan gives you. It is one of the most easiest way to neutralize and mitigate the negative energy which is present in the spaces, in our living spaces. There is another powerful astro remedy which I would like to share. You know, it is said in astrology that whenever there is a pandemic or an epidemic on planet Earth, there is a certain planet which is responsible for causing that pandemic. People who know astrology, they know the impact of Rahu. And Rahu is said to be responsible for creating health disturbances, health problems on this planet Earth. There is a way of protecting your homes from the ill effects, from the negative repercussion or the negative ramification of planet Rahu. Light a bulb in the southwest corner of your homes. Switch on a bulb. If possible, switch on this bulb from sunset till the time you go to sleep. If it is not possible to light a bulb in the southwest corner, you can do it anywhere in the southwest quadrant. Southwest corner is the corner, if you look at the magnetic compass, if you look at the digital compass, because these days people have smartphones. If you look at the 225 degree angle, you will exactly spot the southwest. Anywhere between 220 to 225, you will spot the southwest. If you have a room, if you have a bedroom there, please switch on the light from sunset till the time you go to sleep. If you don't have a light point there, you can switch on a floor lamp. If that is not possible, you can put on a table lamp. If that is not possible, go to the southwest quadrant. Forget the 220 to 225 degree angle. Go to the southwest quadrant and switch on a bulb there. It is one of the most powerful remedies to protect your homes from the negative impact of Rahu. And this can be very easily done. You can use a 0-watt bulb. Don't worry about electricity being wasted, because this remedy can actually create a very powerful protective shield. there is something which is very common, and that problem is so common that we don't even acknowledge that thing as a problem. Doors keep on creaking. They emanate from the doors. This creaking sound keeps on emanating, and this is a problem which is very common. Creaking of the door radiates, emanates, generates so much of negative energy that it is beyond our comprehension. We just, you know, take it very lightly if the doors creak in our homes. Just for a moment, think, where do we usually hear the creaking noise of the doors? Whenever you're watching a horror movie, whenever you're watching a TV series or a web series, which is spooky, which is scary, which is, you know, which has horror content in it, you will keep on hearing the creaking noise which emanates from the door. Creaking sound is an integral part of any horror movie or a horror TV series. If the doors in your house creak, apply oil to the hinges of the door. Lubricate the doors, the hinges. You have to ensure that no creaking noise emanates from the doors. We'll just recap what we discussed. These tips, as I said, are for space cleansing, for space detoxification, for space purgation. So the first part of the talk, I will be highlighting how to neutralize and nullify the negative energy. And the second part of the talk I will be sharing some very interesting tips on how to positivize the space. So the first tip, we'll just recap what we discussed. The first tip was to splash spray salt water. The water has to be lukewarm. You will start from the northeast, come to the southeast, go to the southwest, and then the northwest in a clockwise manner. You keep on spraying, splashing, and sprinkling that water. The second tip was to allow sunlight and morning sunlight if possible. If at all morning sunlight is not possible, then evening sunlight 1 hour before sunset, when the UV radiations are very less. The third tip was to recite Om or Gayatri Mantra in conjunction with lighting a diya. The fourth and the most important tip, which I said is an astro protection, was to light a bulb in the southwest quadrant between sunset and the time you go to sleep. A very important, powerful astro vastu remedy. And the last tip was to oil the hinges of all the doors if your doors are making any creaking noise. Even if they are not making any creaking noise, just as a precautionary measure, you can still apply oil, you can still apply any kind of lubricant to ensure that they don't creak in the future. Once these five vastu tips are incorporated, a complete space cleansing or space detoxification will take place. And once you neutralize the negative energy, which is inherently present in our spaces, then you can start incorporating the suggestions which I'm about to share to increase positive energy in your spaces. The easiest way to enhance, to increase, to activate certain very powerful energy radiations in our homes is a simple ritual that we've been following all these years, you know, from time immemorial. During Diwali, we have this tradition, ritual of lighting a diya outside our homes. Do you know why in our culture, in our tradition, lighting a diya is suggested? What is the reason? Lighting of a diya is such an integral part of our lives. Whether it is a happy moment or a sad moment, we always light a diya. As I said, that we've been doing a lot of research on these energy radiations, and there are certain experiments that we did with diya, and we discovered something very, very interesting. You know, our ancestors were very intelligent. They were people with lot of insight. Whenever you light a flame or you light a diya, there is so much positivity created. How did we discover that lighting of a flame produces positive vibrations or positive radiation? Because we've been experimenting on energy radiations and energy fields, and you know how these subtle vibrations impact our living spaces and our aura. We have instruments through which we identify negative energy radiations. And while we were experimenting, when we identified negative energy radiations in that space, if a flame was introduced, instantly the negative radiations of that space would neutralize, would mitigate. Initially, we were also puzzled as to what was happening. Then the more research we did, we realized that a flame is such a powerful, potent thing that it has the ability to neutralize and nullify any kind of negative energy. Let the intensity be at its maximum. Now, what is the significance of lighting a diya outside the main door of the house? Here, because we are discussing diyas and we are discussing flames, there's something very interesting that I would want to share. You know, during Diwali, there is this wrong custom or wrong system which is followed. People usually light two diyas outside their main door, you know, in the sides of the two door frames. Diyas should always be lit in odd number. Never ever light a flame in even number. Aap diye ko hamesha visham संख्या में जलाएंगे, सम संख्या में दिए को कभी भी नहीं जलाएंगे. दिस सिस्टम ऑफ लाइटिंग टू दियाज आउटसाइड आवर मेन डोर्स इज एक्चुअली नॉट करेक्ट. व्हेनेवर यू लाइट अ दिया, एंश्योर दैट यू लाइट इट इन ऑड नंबर. द मोमेंट यू लाइट अ दिया इन ऑड नंबर, व्हाट हैपेंस एट द लेवल ऑफ एनर्जी इज दैट बिकॉज the main door is the prime source of energy. Main door is the mouth of the house. Ghar mein jo urja aati hai, wo aapke ghar ke mukhya darwaze mein se aati. The energy flow is happening from the main door. The moment you light a diya there, the energy which enters your space, your living space, is instantly positivized. वो ऊर्जा सकारात्मक हो जाती है. एंड यू नो इन दीज अनसर्टेन टाइम्स ऑफ कोविड, दैट इज द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट वी नीड. तो ये दिवाली में ही नहीं, हम हर रोज करेंगे. द बेस्ट टाइम टू लाइट अ दिया विल बी 1 hour बिफोर सनसेट इन द इवनिंग, एंड लेट द दिया कंटिन्यू. If you can light a diya 1 hour before sunset or the time, you know, around sunset, outside the main door, you will be positivizing the energy which is entering your homes. Again, a very simple remedy, but it has very powerful connotations. Second remedy to positivize, to increase, to enhance positive energy in your spaces is again very simple. You have to introduce a water body in the northeast corner of your homes. Water as an element attracts positive energy. Water attracts prosperity. Water is responsible not only for attracting positive energy, but also for accentuating, intensifying the flow of positive energy. Just introduce a simple water body in the northeast corner of your home, and your homes will inundate with positive radiation. It is not necessary that that water body has to be a water fountain. If you don't have a water fountain, you can take a normal flask, fill it with water, and place it in the northeast corner. Northeast corner is that corner where north meets east. If you check the compass on your smartphone, the northeast corner is at 45 degree angle. If it is not possible for any reason to introduce a water body at 45 degree angle, you can place the water body anywhere between 0 to 60 degrees. The moment you place a water body in the northeast quadrant, the positive energy in your spaces will intensify. Again, a very simple remedy. There are things which are, as I said, you know, when I was discussing about the creaking noise of the door, I said there are things which are very common, but we just take it for granted, or we somehow don't consider those things. Any kind of cracked object or an artifact or a showpiece radiates negative energy. कोई भी वस्तु आपके घर में जो खंडित है, चाहे वो पेंटिंग हो, शोपीस हो या आर्टिफैक्ट हो, उसमें से, उस वस्तु में से बहुत ही निषेधात्मक ऊर्जा आती, फ्लो होती. आपको किसी भी क्रैक या खंडित चीज को इमीडिएटली निकाल देना है. अगर आप निकाल नहीं सकते, इफ यू कांट गेट रिड ऑफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट आर्टिफैक्ट और अ पेंटिंग व्हिच इज क्रैक्ड, देन देयर इज अ सिंपल रेमेडी व्हिच कैन बी इनकॉर्पोरेटेड. समटाइम्स इट हैपेंस दैट पीपल हैव वेरी एक्सपेंसिव आर्टिफैक्ट्स एंड पेंटिंग्स, एंड यू नो देयर आर पीपल हु लाइक टू कलेक्ट आर्ट, और देयर आर सर्टेन ऑब्जेक्ट्स, पेंटिंग्स, आर्टिफैक्ट्स, you know, which have sentimental value. If that is the case, there is a simple way of arresting the negative energy flow which is happening from the painting or an artifact or a showpiece. Take a red marker and just do or inscribe a simple om at the back of the painting or an artifact. You have to take a red colored marker and inscribe the OM symbol at the back of the painting or an artifact, and the negative energy which that artifact was emanating will get arrested there. The powerful radiations which OM generates is just beyond our comprehension. You know, these symbols, these Vedic symbols like Om, Swastika, Shri Yantra are very, very powerful energy generating objects. These symbols are so powerful that they can neutralize and negative and nullify the negative energy instantly. Because we are discussing how to increase positive energy, how to enhance positive energy, there is something which is very important and very integral to each one of us. And that is our sleep. Because if we don't sleep well, if our sleep is not peaceful, if our sleep is incomplete, there are a lot of health issues that we face. Not only that, but we don't feel good during the day. We are not our normal selves. Our circadian rhythm also goes for a toss. Because we are talking about Vastu and how to increase positivity in our spaces, it is very imperative for each one of you to know which is the right direction to sleep and why. In Vastu, it is said that people who live in the northern hemisphere, for the countries which lie in the northern hemisphere, that is for the countries which are above the equator, one should sleep with the head towards the south. आपके सिर को दक्षिण दिशा की तरफ रख के सो जाएंगे. There is a scientific reasoning. There is logic behind this. And the logic is that we have pineal gland between our eyebrows here, at where the third eye is. And the pineal gland is magnetosensitive in nature. And pineal gland is also responsible for the production of the sleep hormone, which is called melatonin. When you sleep with your head towards the south, the secretion of melatonin is balanced and you get sound sleep. Such a simple scientific fact. There are people who want to, you know, challenge a lot of things. And when I talk about sleeping in the right direction, they tell me, hum to saalon se north mein sote, humme kuch bhi nahi hua. But these things are not to be challenged. Agar kuch nahi hua, to aapki system, aapki body ne us cheez ko abhi tak manifest nahi kiya hai. Sometimes there is a problem inside the body, but the manifestation of that problem doesn't take place at the physical level. So these things are not to be challenged. Sleeping with your head towards the south will ensure melatonin production, because the pineal gland, which is magnetosensitive in nature, will get rightly activated. If you can't sleep with your head towards the south, there is an alternative direction to sleep. And that alternative direction is to sleep with your head towards the east. You know, there has been this fascinating research done on neurons in our brain. I'm sure there are doctors today present in the attendees, and they will agree to what I'm saying. We have placed neurons in our brain, and those neurons fire differently depending on which direction we face. This has been scientifically proven. When you sleep with your head towards the east, because east is the direction of sunrise, there is a certain energy radiation which is happening from the eastern side. And that energy radiation that happens is so conducive, is so positive for our brains that it is just unimaginable. But a lot of research is still happening. You know, the impact of the vibratory fields of different directions on brains and brain waves and neurons is still at a nascent stage. It is still very embryonic in terms of the research that has been done. But certain things have been certainly, you know, proven beyond doubt. Try and sleep with your head towards the south. If that is not possible, sleep with your head towards the east. Ya to aap dakshin disha ki taraf aapka sar rakh ke soyenge. Agar wo mumkin nahi hai, to aap purv disha ki taraf aapka sar rakh ke soyenge. Because we are discussing the direction which is positive for sleeping, there is something very important that I need to tell you. If you have exposed mirrors in your bedroom, please cover it. Even if your bed is not reflecting in the mirror, even if the bed is not coming in the line of the mirror, if there is an exposed mirror in your bedroom, please cover it. Why? Because mirrors tend to reflect energies. And these days, because there is so much of uncertainty and there is so much of anguish, anxiety, stress in everyone's mind, it is important that we cover all the exposed mirrors in the bedroom. Again, this is a very simple remedy. You can put a piece of cloth on the mirror and cover it. There is no need to permanently do anything. But if the mirror is in the line of the bed or is reflecting the bed, in that scenario, you need to either change the position of the mirror or you need to cover the mirror. Get rid of any dysfunctional gadgets in the house. If you have wall clocks, watches, any gadget which is not working, which is out of order, which has become dysfunctional, please get rid of it. Because any gadget, when it becomes dysfunctional and it stops working, the energy flow in our spaces tend to get clogged. And we want to ensure free flowing energy in our spaces. Whenever the flow of energy in our spaces get clogged, it creates negativity. So if you have gadgets which are dysfunctional, please get rid of those gadgets. You know, our ancestors believed that any kind of leakage that happens from our homes, like, you know, if the taps in your homes leak or the overhead water tank in your homes leak, it was considered as a bad omen. Use apshagun mana jata. There is a reason. And the reason is very scientific, very rational, very mathematical. As I said, that we've been experimenting on these mysterious energy radiations, these subtle energy radiations, these mysterious forces which are present all around us. We were experimenting with an instrument which measures the energy field of a house. And we can actually measure the length of the energy which any house emanates or radiates. What we did was, we let the water flow while we were doing the energy measurement. The moment the water started flowing, there was a slight dip in the energy level of that structure. So, for an example, hypothetically speaking, if your home has an energy field, this can be measured from your main door, of say 5 meters. So the aura of your home is extending say up to 5 meters, and if there is a leakage in your home, you know, if a tap is leaking or your overhead water tank is leaking, the energy tends to instantly reduce, the length of the energy will reduce, and it will come to 4.5 meters. So this instant reduction in the energy which your house was emanating indicates that there is something which gets dissipated from our homes. If there is any kind of leakage, please plug that leakage, because the impact on the net energy field of our homes is very bad. You could create positive energy in your spaces by the tips that I have shared, but some kind of a leakage is not, if there is a leakage and that leakage is not plugged, then the positive energy that you have created will not give you results as per your expectations. So it is very important that we don't allow any kind of leakage to happen in our spaces. Do I have time to share tips for work from home, or I have overshot on my time limit?
You can have 5-10 minutes.
Okay. Because the subject today was health and vastu, so I did not first start with work from home. I know that work from home is a new normal, and though unlocking has gradually begun, but there are a lot of states and there are a lot of areas which are again going for a lockdown. So work from home is the new reality. Because work from home is the new reality, I would want to share some very interesting vastu suggestions. If you are a professional, if you are a teacher, if you are an engineer, if you are an IT professional, if you are a software professional, if you are a HR consultant, and you have to work from home, face the East. East is the direction of knowledge. For any working professional, East is the direction. Aap purv disha ki or dekhenge. If you are a businessman, if you are an entrepreneur, if you are into any kind of manufacturing activity, if you are a trader, if you buy and sell, if you are a stockbroker, if you are a stock investor, face the north. Uttar disha bahut hi positive result degi aapko. For businessmen, entrepreneurs, people who have invested their own money and are doing their own business, north is the direction. Also for people who are into knowledge-based industry. There are people who have their own IT businesses or software businesses, or there are people, who are into professional activity where they don't work for anyone, but they are professionals and they have invested their own money in the work that they are doing. For them, Northeast is the direction. जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि आपके डिजिटल फोन में जो कंपस है वहां पे जो 45 डिग्री एंगल है वो नॉर्थ ईस्ट है. सो इफ यू फेस द नॉर्थ ईस्ट दैट विल गिव यू फैंटास्टिक रिजल्ट्स. नाउ आई वुड वांट टू शेयर एन इमेज विथ यू बिकॉज इट इज वर्क फ्रॉम होम. आई वुड वांट टू शेयर दिस इमेज. If you can, I hope the image is clear to everyone. So these three different locations that I have shown in the plan, you know, these three different positions.
Can't see your screen.
Is it clear now?
No.
Is it?
No, it's not visible.
Now?
No.
No.
I'm sorry if this is not visible. Is this image visible?
No, you have not completed the screen sharing.
I have not completed the screen sharing. Just give me 1 minute. Just give me 1 minute, please. Okay, now?
Yes, now it's sharing. Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Now we can see.
So these are three different negative positions that have to be avoided. Look at the first position here. If you have your desk in the line of the door or door on the opposite side of your working area, okay, you are technically sitting in the door line. Now, this is a negative position to sit and work. Never ever sit in a door line. Because door line is an area from where the energy movement is happening at great speed. You know, the energy is moving at such swift speed that it completely disturbs your efficiency. The work that you are doing goes for a toss. Never ever sit in a door line. Now look at the second image. You should never sit with your back facing the door. If your door is hitting your back, that will also disrupt the work that you are doing. The third image, if you can see, is this guy sitting here on a sofa where his sides are in the line of the door. Even sitting in this particular position is completely negative. Here, the right side is being cut by the door. Whichever side is being cut, whether the front portion is being cut, the back portion is being cut, or your sides are being cut, it gives the same result. Never ever sit in a door line. Now, there is something else which is there in this image, which again, you will have to look at the image. If you can look at these dotted lines, the red dotted lines in these three images, these dotted lines are beam lines. So if somebody is sitting under a beam, that is also a negative way to sit. It is a negative position. Never ever sit under a beam. If you are sitting under a beam and the door is in the line of the desk, or the door is cutting your desk or your table, it is a double whammy. दो दोष उत्पन्न हो जाते हैं, एक तो बीम का दोष और दूसरा जब आप दरवाजे की लाइन में बैठते हैं. सो यू विल नेवर एवर सिट इन अ डोर लाइन एंड यू विल नेवर सिट अंडर अ बीम. So, facing the right direction itself is not enough. You have to be very careful that you don't sit in the door line and you don't... Am I audible?
Yes.
And you don't sit under a beam. Because it is work from home and, you know, there are chances that we need... We do tend to, you know, laze around and we do tend to get a little lazy while working. And unknowingly, we might sit touching the bathroom wall. Even if your chair is touching the bathroom wall, from a vastu perspective, it is a negative way to sit. Never ever sit with your chair or your back directly touching the bathroom wall. Why? Because bathroom wall is a wall of disintegrating energy. Bathroom is a place from where energy tends to get drained off. So if you're doing any constructive work and if your chair or your back is touching the bathroom wall, you will not get the kind of results that you were expecting. So these tips were from... if you are working from home and these very important tips will actually help you. These are again very simple tips to follow, very easy tips to follow. You can face the right direction, you can avoid sitting under a beam, you can avoid sitting under a you can avoid sitting in a door line, you can also avoid sitting with your back touching the bathroom wall. With this, I end my today's talk on Vastu. Thank you for being such a patient audience. And I sincerely hope and pray that we all collectively fight this China organized virus in December very effectively. And over to you, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you.